There was a real hard-nosed general, just kind of like that general that's just like, you know, just kind of cold-hearted, just the typical general, cold-hearted, and he's just, he's almost to the point where they think he's sadistic, like he has no thought, no feelings for people, no emotions. And this guy is just, he's a hard-nosed like you have never seen. And they go forth into battle, and there was a man that was just side by side with when they go forth into battle, and they get in a hot part of the battle. You know, and this is the general that's with him, and the enemy approaches to the point where they're crossing swords. They're hand in hand. They're not just back there firing cannons. They're not coming in on a horse. They're on their feet, and they are face to face with the enemy with a sword in their hand. And they're battling and fighting, and the guy who's with him, he looks over, and the enemy comes in and lands one all the way just from right to left, east to west on this guy's body. Said it sliced the guy's face pretty much in half. His nose is like falling off. His lips are cut in half. The guy's eyes lost one of his eyes, and he cut his arm, severed his arm in half. And that colonel, that hard-nosed, strong fighting colonel, that guy dropped his sword because the sword was in that hand. So he walked over to that guy. It's at the end of the battle. You know what most people would do if you were him? You'd go over in a corner somewhere and die like an animal somewhere. You'd live your last few minutes in sorrow and in pain crying, wouldn't you? That colonel went over while that guy was on the sitting down. He was sitting down on his butt. He went over and he picked up his sword that he had dropped because his arm was cut off, and he put it in the other guy's hand, and the regiment was 57. That's what they were a part of. Put that sword back in his hand and he said, "Die hard, 57, die hard." That guy got up, he had the sword, I'm assuming, in his opposite hand. It'd be like me going forth in a battle with a sword in my left hand. You know what he did? He died fighting. He died, you know, enduring hardness. Instead of dying somewhere and giving up, even after he had been injured, even after, you know, he had suffered what would have been a fatality, his last few breaths, you know what he did? He died with the sword in his hand. He died on the battlefield fighting. There are many reasons why people stop fighting. There are multiple reasons why people stop fighting. They walk off. But ultimately, it's because it's too hard and too tough and they don't want to fight anymore. It's just too tough. It's too hard. And they just walk off the battlefield, or if they're too injured, they just lay there. When they have enough in them, you're going to die anyways. Hey, I'm going to die one day anyway. I'm going to take my last breath anyways. Let me tell you, I want to die on the battlefield. Amen. I want to die fighting. I'm going to die with the sword in my hand, I can guarantee it. Hey, there may be a lot of people that have grown, you know, to not like me. There may be a lot of people that don't like my preaching. They don't like the things that I say. They think I preach against them, whatever they say. But one thing, if you know me well, you know that I'm going to die with that sword in my hand. I'm going to die fighting. I don't care if everybody leaves the church. I don't care what happens. I'm going to die on the battlefield. I'm going to die fighting with the sword in my hand. That's not changing. Yes. Die hard, 57. Die hard. I don't care if I lose an arm. Right. If both my arms are chopped off, I'm going to kick you. If I lose my legs, I'll crawl over to you and I'll cut your legs off. Yes. I'm going to die fighting. I don't care what happens. I'm going to clench. You know what happens if I suffer an injury? I'm going to hold on to the sword even tighter. I'm going to cleave to the sword even tighter.